Well, hey there. My name's Josh Pitka. I'm the lead pastor of Dunamis Church, Sarnia. Today is Friday, August 22nd today. Today is actually my daughter's due date, so we're just patiently waiting and excited for our baby girl, Davina, to be born today, hopefully today. So that's an awesome, awesome thing. This morning in our morning prayer meeting, I really felt the Lord ministering to me in the area of restoration. And I felt like he gave me a word for the church, definitely my church, but also just the church at large. If you're a believer and if you feel like in your life, man, I feel like there's things that need to be restored to me. There's maybe relationships that need to be restored to me. Maybe a marriage that needs to be restored, or finances, or opportunities that need to be restored. And I felt like, I feel the Holy Spirit just right now as I'm mentioning that. And I really feel like even as you're listening to this right now, that the Lord is wanting to speak a word to you to restore your heart and to bring just a release of restoration into your life. And the reason why I would put this on a video and put it on the internet and put it on YouTube or on Facebook or however you access this video is because the Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. So in the context of where that scripture went, when that scripture is written in Romans chapter 10, I believe it's verse either 9 or 10, or maybe it's 15, it's somewhere in Romans chapter 10, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. The context in that verse, that verb, faith, is a present tense context. It means, or the verb hearing, is a present tense context. It doesn't mean having heard. So it's not just an accumulation of Bible stories or reading the Bible or sermons or something like that. Faith comes by hearing God now. And I believe I have a word from God. That's why I would bother taking the time to put this on the internet, because I really believe that hearing this word can release faith inside of your heart and release a passion, a resolve to say, oh God, yes, that's me. I need things restored in my life. And if that's you, if you know, if you have a witness in your spirit with this word right now, just say that with me. Yes, God, that's me. Bring restoration into my life. In Jesus' name, amen. And the word that I just felt come to me, I felt like the Lord said, Joel, go to Joel this morning. And in verse 20 it says, God speaking, I will remove the northerner far from you. That's the army that was against the Israelites, this great army, and drive him into the parched and desolate land. His vanguard, or his face, into the eastern sea, and his rear guard into the western sea. The stench and foul smell of him will rise, for he has done great things. In other words, present tense context to your situation, I really sense the Lord saying, I will break the back of the enemy in your life. The things that have come against you, the things that even the Lord has allowed to come against you, to bring training and to bring strength and to cause you to persevere and to cause you to be strengthened. You know, oftentimes the Lord will allow circumstances in our lives in order to test our faith and see if our faith is genuine. And probably if you're watching this video right now, your faith is genuine, because otherwise you would have clicked off of this right now and gone and done something else. But if you're still watching along right now, I believe the Lord is saying to you that your faith is genuine, and God has tested your faith, and you are coming out of this season right now. Maybe you're right in the middle of the season. You're going to come out of it in a month, or in a few months, or maybe even a year. But for a lot of you, you know, man, this season is done. And the Lord wants me to tell you that you're coming out of this season of testing, this season where it feels like all hell is broken loose in your life, and you're coming into a place of prosperity and into a place of peace. Verse 21 in Joel 2 says, fear not, O land. Be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. Fear not, you beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness are green. The tree bears its fruit. The fig tree and the vine give their full yield. And I believe the Lord is saying through this that He wants you again to increase. That He wants you again. He wants your tree to bear fruit. He wants your life to bring forth the fragrance of Jesus Christ in your ministry and your calling to blossom again. Verse 23, be glad, O children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for He has given, this is awesome, the early rain for your vindication. He has poured down for you abundant rain, the early and latter rain as before. And God is saying, out of this season, as your faith has increased, there is a fresh rain. There is the rain that you had before, the relationship, the presence of God, the anointing that you had before, but there's a fresh anointing. There's a new anointing. There's something more that God is going to add to your life and add to your ministry and add to the substance of who you are. A fresh rain. It's not just the latter rain. It's the new rain. It's the abundant rain. And for many of you watching this, that there's a fresh anointing. There's a new anointing on your life. There's a fresh grace. There's a fresh zeal to do the calling and to do the works that the Lord has called you to do. In verse 24 says, the threshing floors shall be full of grain, the vats overflow with wine and oil. I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the hoppering locust, the destroying locust, the cutting locust, my great army which I sent among you. I will destroy those tests and those challenges because you've come through. You've repented. You're seeking me. You're going for it. And I will fill your threshing floors again. In other words, you're going to bear more fruit than you've ever known before. You're going to be successful in the endeavors that God has called you to. And that is His plan for your life. Verse 26, you shall eat plenty in the land and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never again be put to shame. You shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and I am the Lord your God, and there is none else. And my people shall never be put to shame. And just lastly, I believe the Lord wants to say that that shame that you felt even in your past or past mistakes or whatever, that God is breaking that thing off of you. And you are going to run the race with perseverance, the race that is set before you. And you are never going to back down again. And you're going for this thing, that you're going for Jesus with all of your heart. You're going after Him with all of your life. So just receive this word right now. Let a fresh faith, let a fresh anointing, let a fresh zeal be imparted into your spirit, into your mind, to be restored, to be completely forgiven, completely restored and set free. And take this word and just say again, I receive that restoration. I receive all that God has for me. And I'm going to run the race with Jesus, the race that is set before me, keeping my eyes on Jesus, my eyes on the prize, my eyes on all of His promises, everything He said for me. I'm going for it all. Bless you today. And I pray this word has encouraged your heart.